Welcome to part 11 of the Sonic Adventure 2 Let's Play. As you saw last part, I didn't really get a chance to finish Death Chamber because the video was almost 20 minutes and I really didn't want that. So I had to end off a horrible note. Luckily though, I was able to edit this in. So, progress? Question mark? Oh well, but we already saw how the level. So, what that small flash said. I was actually surprised because the key placement was actually not as obnoxious as last part. Because none were actually hidden in the walls, floors, etc. etc. Okay, so. This is where, quite a bit of cutscene. Yeah, another thing with the Dark Side story compared to the Hero Side story, at least in my opinion, it's more cutscene heavy. I mean, I could be wrong. You can go into the comment section and correct me all you want. But really, that's what generally I think, and it, well, makes sense. Oh yeah, and Rouge used a, space teleporter. What was the point of the space shuttle? Oh well. Anyway, now we have Lost Colony. Alright, once again, if you haven't played the first the Hero Side story, then this is the first arc level that you're gonna play. Not a very good first arc level, I have to say, because really, I'm sorry with my skills, ladies and gentlemen. Even though I'm doing somewhat passable. But here's the thing. It's dark. Like, Kelp Forest dark. I can see a little better on the computer screen. In fact, I'm seeing a little bit better right now. And as you viewers, you're going to probably see it better than me. But whenever I try to look at it on the TV screen, wow, it's dark. Heck, I don't know if this is supposed to be a cosmetic hick thing in with Lost Colony, because this is where Eggman first finds the Ark. And the Ark itself, you know, it's desolate, empty, lifeless. So obviously the lighting has to be dark, has to be mysterious. But to this extent, this is ridiculous. But hey, we are getting another new upgrade, which is the, I hate explosions in this game. Anyway, now we have the jet engine, which is pretty much the same thing as the hover boost, just with tails, so not really missing much. Okay, yeah, oh, I thought it was an artificial chow. Chow or artificial. No, what I meant to say was artificial chaos. I thought I hit an artificial chaos, which was pretty much a chow box. And I missed the checkpoint. There's no way to get back up. So I had to beat the level I had to get to the next checkpoint without dying. Hopefully dying doesn't happen. And spoiler warning, it doesn't. But, when it comes to Lost Colony itself, it's really just an easier version of Eternal Engine. And so, when it comes to level design, when you boil it down, it's not as horrendous as Eternal Engine. I mean, that's not saying much, because the lighting is awful. I get what it's supposed to be, but I can't really see on my TV screen. I mean, really? Come on. Stuff like that happens, where I get ambushed. Like that. Oh, with these elevator segments, I just like, you know, with these elevator segments, I actually do like tilting the analog stick all around, go crazy, going like crazy mode. Well, that's actually the best way to gain a lot of points in this level. And yes, I still have a bit of a sore mouth. I apologize if I'm not talking as much. Oh man, oh. Ugh. So, how about that, oh yeah, the recording curse doesn't really get me as much as the last two parts, so that shouldn't be. I mean, the recording curse does happen, just not as much. But yeah, you know. What's the point? What's the point of destroying in the crates? It's in fact, when it comes to certain gates, why have the switch right in front of the gate itself? Why can't it just open automatically? But that was Lost Colony, and we have one giant cutscene coming up. D ranks. All right, so central control room on the space colony Ark. Sorry, I'm thinking out loud. Okay. Okay, so this is getting into one of the most controversial moments, I should say. Well, until Shadow of the Hedgehog. Well, one of the biggest questions in Sonic history. This is the Eclipse Cannon, and as Shadow mentioned, it's capable of destroying an entire planet. Okay, but we all know the whole story behind Professor Gerald, so why would he have the cannon? Why would he have the cannon before? Or before the gun raid? Yeah. I don't know if I should classify that as a spoiler, but since it kind of happened in a small flashback right before we started Radical Highway, I'm just going to assume that it's a safe one. And oh yes. You know, at the games after this, Shadow has never acted so evil, in a sense. And so, granted, he's doing this for revenge, and obviously, but when it boils down to how evil it can be, I think this game actually gets first place in when it comes to that aspect. And no, I'm not counting the non-canon ending. I'm not counting the non-canon and dark endings. He's from Shadow the Hedgehog. They're not canon, obviously. We all know how great that game was. Okay. I'm surprised no one has asked where she came from. Okay. All right, so that was a cutscene. Now we have this one, which only adds up. All right, we're gonna be learning why exactly Eggman is at the military base. Or more importantly, how did Amy come in? Like, how did Amy show up? We're gonna be finding that out in this episode. By the way, when Eggman said dynamite packs, I was actually gonna say, when he said it used these dynamite packs to blow up the whole island, and it's like, yeah, all one of them. Okay, so now we're gonna be ending this with another mech section. Welcome to Weapons Bed. Weapons Bed pretty much shares the same trope as Mel Harbor. And as you can probably guess, when it comes to an A rank, that's not a good sign. It's not really hard per se. I mean, I haven't gotten the A rank, but it's not really hard, but it's still kind of weird. You see, the gimmick with the weapons bed is that there's a bunch of deactivated gun robots that you can shoot for points. Now, and you can even lock onto multiple little targets. Get a bigger score. Alright, so that's all fine and right. Here's the thing. I've heard some people saying that they locked onto many targets as they could, but only to not get an A rank. Now, I don't want to rip off anyone else here. I don't want to rip off of Clement yet. Yeah, I'm kind of referencing this guy a lot, am I? Call this one of my main gimmicks with my channel. I'm referencing other channels. Don't ask why. It's what I do. Alright. From what he said, the cap with getting a perfect, I think, is 11 targets. It's any more higher, and you're not going to get a good... Well, you're not going to get a good score for some reason. I really don't know how that works. But lock on to 11 targets at a time, and you might get see how that works. Because I haven't tried it myself, and I'm really not going to get a good ranking in this level. Again, spoiler warning. But something ends up screwing me over. I think it's at this section. I'm not too sure. Oh, well. I really hate that. That's one thing I always found annoying in Sonic Adventure 2 and just in the levels in general. Explosions. And it's just, stuff like that happens. And it's a lot. That the residue will actually damage you. And then you suffer knockback. And we all know how wonderful knockback is in video games. And I'm at the very end of the stage. Give me a break. Oh yeah, and we got another upgrade, which pretty much lets us destroy the iron containers. I thought I'd say that right now. Screw you, explosions. I didn't get a good rank. Meh. Meh. Oh. Okay, so we are now gonna figure out how did Amy appear? Or how come she appeared? Your eyes don't deceive you. So I guess the whole preview-ish thing, I should say. I guess that whole aspect was just a complete waste of time, because she appears out of nowhere. Amy really does get around. Oh, man. And I think that's one of the Actually, with that little glimpse, it's probably the only time where we're actually gonna see Eggman wearing his goggles. Okay, so now we have our first mech boss on the Dark Side story. Spoiler warning, I mess up. Okay, so next time we meet, guys, we're gonna be doing everyone's favorite treasure hunting stage. So see you then. Good day.